al rey de Irizarry. Hacer una cosa increíble. Ahora se tienen que ir, tranca la cámara, por favor, porque qué. Ok, chao, bye. Dame un momento, por favor.
Ralph Irizarry, recognized worldwide as a top percussionist, fell in love with the timbale at an early age when his father brought home a set received as payment for a debt.
I remembered that when I was 8 years old, there was a drug addict who owed my father $25. And he would hide from my father every time my father came, you know, from work. So finally he said, yo, I got some timbales I could give you for the $25, because I'm tired of avoiding you already. So my father said, yeah, that he'll take the timbales. It was that or nothing. And he brought the timbales to the house. And I remember when we got those timbales, I was 8 years old. We always used to play on the covers of the steams, you know, these like aluminum or steel covers that used the steam from the house. And we always used to jam on that. That was all, we were always, my sister and my brothers. When we got those timbales, they had the real calf skins.
Oh yeah, sure.
So we took these sticks off of the hangers, you know, the wooden hangers had these sticks, and we banged the hell out those timbales, and we broke the skins the same day.
A self-taught musician, Irizarry has developed a highly efficient and personalized style of playing while leaving an enduring mark on the artists with whom he has collaborated. His love for the instrument evolved into a full-fledged passion that has fueled his career since 1970.
My life was going to school and getting home as soon as possible so that I could go in my basement, take off my shirt, and put on whatever of the 5 or 6 or 7 records that came out that week that I would buy. I mean, I would go to the record store and say, what came out this week? And at that time, Fania and all these other record companies, they were like factories. They had stuff coming out every month, you know, or every week. That's how I learned how to play with records. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I would, it's funny because one day I was so involved in practicing that I didn't see my father's wheels go by of the car. So I'm into it and I'm playing. And for some reason or other, I turn around and my father was like at the bottom of the steps of the basement. And he had like a tear coming out of his eye. You know, he had never heard me play because I used to stop, you know, he never knew that I was like getting into playing music. And, you know, and he told me after he saw me, he said, you know, you don't have to stop playing when I get home. You can continue to play if you want to, you know?
Yeah.
So that was like a real special moment.
Viene el bajo de Santo Domingo, Rey Martínez.
Finally got my big break with Ray Barreto, who, after a two-year absence of playing because he had broken his hand, and that was when he was, you know, doing his Eye of the Beholder and all these other things where he, you know, wasn't playing the Cuchifrito circuit, you know, and he wasn't playing, like, dance music. He went into a little bit more of a fusion of what he liked because he loved jazz. He decided to come back, so he had to make a band. After Ray Barreto, or while I was playing with Ray Barreto, I got offered the Rubén Blades gig.
Envueltos entre sombras. infierno. Mientras no haya justicia, jamás tendremos paz. Viviendo dictaduras, te busco y no te encuentro. Tu torturado cuerpo no sabe dónde está.
When I hit those timbales, something happened. Something inside of me happened. It's like love at first sight. You know, I really dug it. I didn't want to have anything to do with girls or partying or going to parties or anything. My life was going to school and getting home as soon as possible so that I could go in my basement, take off my shirt, and put on whatever of the 5 or 6 or 7 records that came out that week that I would buy. I mean, I would go to a record store and say, what came out this week? And at that time, Fania and all these other record companies, they were like factories. They got stuff coming out every month, you know, or every week. That's how I learned how to play with records.
Tonight I'm using all of the cowbells and jam block from Tycoon Percussion, as well as my signature series timbal, 14, 15 inch Ralph Irizarry signature model. Thank you.
finally started doing touring with Seis de Solal, the instrumental Latin jazz group, for once, I finally got how it felt to get applause for what we were doing without a singer up front. Mm-hmm. You know, it felt so great. You know, all these hours of rehearsing and practicing and all that stuff. When we started to get like sometimes standing ovations and stuff like that, and I look around, I said, did Rubén Blades just come out of the, you know, why are these people applauding, you know? And it was actually for us. So once I got a taste of that, then I started to say, okay, I think I could put together something where, you know, the band is what's going on, you know? And then since I've never played traps, I knew it was gonna be a Latin jazz band, but in the true sense of the word,
right.
Because there weren't gonna be no traps. It was gonna be timbal and conga. I want to go that route, timbal and conga, you know, on steroids, sort of, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And push that envelope and see what happens, you know?
Yeah.
And that's when Timbalaya came about.
Thank you.
everybody. My name is Rafa Irizarry, timbalero with Rubén Blades, my own group, Timbalaye, an actor in the Mambo Kings. You're watching Salsa en la Calle.